Gordon Hayward now, he had an up and down season last year for the Celtics, as we remember, but he's feeling really confident entering this season. Here's what he told Mass Live about his off-season workouts. Reps is what gives you confidence. So being able to do things over and over and not worry about how my ankle's feeling or having to be cautious with it has really been good, especially for my confidence. Going into a summer training as hard as I want to, it's a lot better for my confidence this year and expectations-wise as well. He said confidence like four times in there. Royce, well, how do you feel that how Hayward will perform this season?
Yeah, and I think that's a lot of it, Brian. You know, I spent a lot of time around Paul George, and his injury was compared very directly with Gordon Hayward, and they spent a lot of time talking to each other. And one of the things Paul would repeat to me often is that it wasn't just the physical confidence, it's the mental confidence of knowing that you can go up in traffic, go up for an alley-oop, take contact on a layup or whatever, and come down and not even think about it. It's not even just having the confidence to land, but to do it over and over again to the point where it's never even in your mind
just
that you might
get hurt.
Second
nature, like it's always been.
Right, yeah, like it's a layup drill. And that's so much of it, is that's truly, from what Paul would say, is kind of brought back the explosiveness.
One thing we have to remember about Gordon Hayward's recovery, he had to have a follow-up surgery. Mm-hmm. I know it was just an arthroscopic procedure, but he wasn't healing correctly, and they had to go back in, make a correction, so he had to start his rehab over again. So when he came back last year, he hadn't had a year off. He had had a couple of months where he'd been able to recover from that, and that's important to remember, because I think everybody's, oh yeah, he broke his leg, and then he came back a year later, but he had difficulty in his recovery. Matt, obviously, you've recovered from injuries. You've been around guys recovering from injuries. Yeah. It's a real process.
I think the biggest key is I never had an injury that big. I had a meniscus tear when I was with the Lakers, and I know from personal experience, the biggest thing is coming back and trusting, like he mentioned, your knee, your ankle, whatever the situation may be, getting over the fact that, you know, most likely he's going to sprain that same ankle that he broke, and I know that's in the back of his mind. Like, I hope this doesn't happen. So, just more time, but I initially said when he came back, you're not going to see the, you know, Gordon that we're accustomed to until this upcoming season, because it just takes time. It took Paul George some time, mm-hmm. and, you know, he nearly won MVP last year. So, you know, I definitely think Gordon is going to have a big season, and the Celtics are going to need it.
I look at two factors here. 2 years removed from the ankle injury, so that almost like a player coming off an ACL, takes them certainly a while to recover. And when I look at this Boston roster, there's less mouths to feed. You have no Kyrie Irving, you have no Terry Rozier. They've got the back of the bench is with young players. They've got four draft picks there. And I think his role is going to probably be defined a little bit more this year.
Let me ask you about that. Considering that their bench is thinner than it's been, and considering he did play off the bench last year, is he come in as a starter or is he come in as a bench player?
I think he's a starter. I think you're going to probably put Jayson Tatum at the four, and you're going to put Jaylen Brown probably at the two, and Hayward comes off at the three. And I think you probably have an eight or nine man rotation, and your bench guys are more of your developmental projects here. And I think last year you had probably too much talent, where you were Terry Rozier, mm-hmm. who had started in those playoffs when Kyrie was out, now is coming off the bench. Now he's looking for those, you know, 25 to 30
Jaylen
minutes.
Brown had to withdraw.
Yeah, Jaylen Brown had an off year. Jayson Tatum had an off year. And I think now your rotation kind of shrinks a little bit.
They were kind of trying to find a position for Gordon Hayward to play a lot, too. It was, does he play the three? Does he play the four? He went from starter to bench. So it was in and out, and it was uncomfortable all season long for him. And so maybe like Bobby said, he finds some confidence with that.
I think the biggest thing is that I think they had too much talent too. They'll have defined roles, and as a player, that's what you need, that's what you lean on, because he came back and started, then he came off the bench. Guys were confused, they didn't know their roles, and you saw the younger players take a step back. I think the younger players take a big step forward, and Gordon Hayward's going to be a big part of that.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For more sports highlights and analysis, be sure to download the ESPN app. And for live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.